Coming up on Sports Weekly, the Cajon Cowboys open the 2017 season with a big win at Paloma Valley, while Aquinas stormed past Big Bear in Week 0. We'll also hear from the new head coach at Arrowhead Christian, Dustin Davis. That's coming up on Sports Weekly. Welcome back to Sports Weekly. Going into the football season, the Cajon Cowboys knew their non-league schedule would put them to the test and prepare them from the Citrus Belt League. Cajon has three very tough non-league games to open the year, and the Cowboys are off to a great start. Cajon collided with Paloma Valley to kick off the season, and it was the marquee matchup in Week 0. There's Nick Rogers, the head coach at Cajon. The Cowboys raced out to a 28-7 lead on the Wildcats, and they held on for a 44-34 victory. Cajon dual threat quarterback Jaden Daniels threw for 168 yards, rushed for 85 more, ran for that touchdown, he threw for two more. Cajon also scored two defensive touchdowns, including that scoop and score for Jeremiah Martin, ripped the ball right out of the ball carrier's hands, 40 yards on the touchdown. Joseph Yarber had a big game for the Cowboys. There he is as he paced the ground game with 165 rushing yards. So Cajon will now take aim on Division I Murrieta Valley following a bye week, but the Nighthawks are not exactly flying high right now. Murrieta Valley was on the losing end of the biggest upset in Week 0. Santiago scored the game-winning touchdown as time expired to pull off a 30-28 win against the Nighthawks. So Murrieta Valley will look to bounce back with two consecutive games against some really good teams from out of the Citrus Belt League. The Nighthawks get Redlands this Friday, and then it's Cajon in Week 2, which should be Cajon's home opener at their new stadium on campus. The CIF Southern Section unveiled its preseason rankings, and it wasn't a huge shock to see Aquinas high atop the Division 9 poll. The Falcons are coming off a run to the championship game in Division 10, so they've been bumped up to Division 9, and they enter the season as the second-ranked team. Aquinas kicking off the year at home against the Big Bear Bears. And wow, what a game it was. The Falcons have almost everyone returning from last year's team that reached the D-10 final, including that guy, running back Brandon Rankins, who ran wild on Big Bear. He ran for five touchdowns, his longest going for 34 yards. Meanwhile, quarterback Sayu Cisse ran for a touchdown, threw for a score, that one going to Joshka Gustav. Going to get a lot tougher, though, for Aquinas as the Falcons travel to Crespi in Encino for a Week 1 matchup. Over at Arrowhead Christian, the Eagles are coming off a 40-0 victory against Southlands Christian. The Eagles are flying high with new head coach Dustin Davis. ACA fields close to 40 players on the varsity roster, and Davis likes the competition he sees at practice. It'll only make the team better before they embark into the Ambassador League against the likes of Aquinas, Notre Dame, and the rest of the league. ACA will travel to Big Bear this Saturday. Here's Coach Davis.
It's definitely a little bit of a challenge coming in that late because, you know, normally by April, you've got plans set up for spring ball. You've got, you know, all your drills set and all your, your scheme, you know, how you're teaching your scheme. So that was, you know, we were a little bit behind. But I think we caught up well over the summer. The biggest challenge is just our numbers are low. So, having enough guys to, you know, get a full practice in, those kind of things. Those are some of the things we're dealing with. But, the kids seem hungry. The guys are showing up and working hard in the weight room. They were working hard all summer. I think we've got a good mix of talent. We've got a good mix of leadership from all levels. We've got some competition in spots. I like what I see. I like how we stack up at certain positions. It's just going to come down to our health, really. We've got to get a little bit more efficient in our execution. And I think once we do that, we can be a pretty good team.
Well, thank you for watching Sports Weekly. Be sure to check out all the shows and videos on the IE Media Group YouTube channel. And if you haven't already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Our live sports coverage is in full swing for the fall season. I'm Pep Fernandez, and thank you for watching Sports Weekly on IEMG.